Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2. Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2. Cool. All right. What's up, everybody? Happy Friday. What's up, Eric? Welcome, welcome. Time to play some Vanquish. Time to play some more Vanquish. Here we go. What's up, Alan? How's it going, man? Hope everyone is having a good week. I'm doing splendid, man. How are you? Has anyone watched Fallout yet? I started watching that last night, and man, that show is shockingly good. I don't know if it's kind of like the Halo show, in that if you don't know anything about the games, you'll like it. Whereas if you know the games, you might hate it. That's, you know, very possible. But yeah, I am really enjoying that show. It's very, very good so far. I've never been much of a Fallout guy. So, maybe that helps. But I started my new job yesterday. It's going good. Oh, nice. That's good to hear, man. Very good to hear. Hopefully, I might have finally found a tiler for my bathroom this year. It's annoying. I want to start getting things in motion for that. So... what's up, Henry? I mean, that's kind of the thing, isn't it? You know, video game adaptations are always a bit like, you know, you always think, this is probably going to be garbage. But yeah, that Fallout show, man, is really, really good. I'm really surprised how good that is. And I mean, again, I don't know. I'm not a Fallout guy, but I don't know if it's got anything to do with the show. I don't know if it's got anything to do with the game. So, you know, I don't know. But, like, even I'm noticing a few things in there. Alright, 1 second, guys. What's up, Lipidi? Welcome. Love the commentary run of PN3. What a fucking, like, chat of culture we have right now in the YouTube chat. A PN3 fan, I salute you. All right, let me get set up here. I am going through this and getting all the statues. I forgot how many statues there are in this game. Oh, there's way too many. There's way too many collectibles in this game. I must admit, I kind of forgot about that. So yeah, I have a video that I'm following to get all the collectibles. Because, oh my god, there are so many. Anyway, you guys can't even see anything yet. Where's chat? There we go. Pow! There we go. Right. Okay. I mean, it depends, Valen. It's not always the case. But I think it's just that video games are inherently more difficult to adapt because they are... there's so much more to them. Well, that's not actually... yeah, that's not true always, actually. I think it's pretty crazy that they haven't managed to do, like, a good Resident Evil adaptation yet. I think Resident Evil is literally a haunt... like, it's a monster movie in a haunted house. I feel like that film kind of makes itself, and yet... yeah, they haven't managed... like, the first Resident Evil film is kind of the best one they've made, and that's not much of a compliment. Like, I do like the first Resident Evil movie. I think it you know, it works as a zombie movie, but I think, you know, nothing about that film is, you know, improved or anything by it being a Resident Evil movie, if that makes sense. But anyway, let's crack on here. What's up, Rizzle? What's up, June? Oh, I will have fun. Yeah, I am enjoying this, but I must admit, I can't wait to get all the bloody collectibles out of the way. There's so many collectibles in this game. There's so many. And also, I really just want to play the PC version. Because I gotta tell you, man, the PS3 version, it ain't it. It's really not. It's really not it, man. This version is, like, leaves a lot to be desired. I gotta tell you. I'm kind of charging ahead for the collectible here, so I might get killed. The laser seed. Yeah, I mean, that's kind of my point, though. Like, The fact that, like, that is the most iconic scene in the film is kind of, you know, kind of my point. Are they actually going to kill that, or... I should have grabbed the shotgun. I'm on the PS3 version because I never played this on PS3 way back when, and I just want the platinum, honestly. There we go. I just want the easy platinum. All right, where's the next one? But yeah, Fallout Show is very good. I would recommend. What's up, Sam? Right, where's the next one? I just have a video here that I'm checking. But yeah, there's 4 statues in every single mission. Okay, that's not for a while. And I just think, man, that's way too many. I don't think Vanquish is underrated, because I feel like anyone who's played it, like, knows how good it is. I think it's more just underappreciated. Like, it's... There are still quite a few... There's still a lot of people that have no idea this game, like, exists. And that's just such a shame. I am going to get rid of this, because otherwise it's going to hold up my demons. I don't think I need this sniper rifle anymore, though. You know one thing I do like when you upgrade the sniper rifle, though, is that it gets a tripod look. Which I think is kind of cool. There we go. Right, so I have to get past this bit for the next one, don't I? Yeah. Yeah, it is bizarre. I mean, you can play it that way. And honestly, it's still kind of fun. It's still fun to play it that way. It's just not nearly as fun as playing it, you know, the way that I feel like, you know, they meant for you to play it. You know what's funny is that on normal and easy in this part, you can literally just use your machine gun to kill those tanks, because, like, your assault rifle is just so powerful on easy. And it came out in Cover Shooter Fever, you know. Which is interesting, because I don't know if anyone is familiar, but this game took around 3 years. Did that not kill him? This game took around 3 years to develop, right? So, I have a feel... I don't think this was, like, totally reactionary to Gears of War, personally. Because Gears of War, like, the time between, you know, this Gears of War and this game is not long enough for them to actually... Oh, crap. There's a trophy there, isn't there? I swear there's a trophy for not losing a tank there. You know what? Fuck it. I'll do it on easy. But yeah, you know, like, that time is not enough for them to, you know, kind of develop this idea and make it. So I wonder if, you know, they had more of, like, a PN3 DMC approach for this. And then they kind of, the cover was kind of the last thing they added. Because I feel like that's way easier than them doing it the other way. I was really not paying attention to you. Oh, it's fine. We don't need them anyway. We don't need them anyway. Yeah, so if we go title screen. Because I also want to get the no death trophy here, so. But yeah. What's up, Mira? And also, like, you know one thing about this game that even at the time was kind of cringe? And I keep forgetting to change the dialogue. The dialogue and the story in that in this game is, oh man, it's real bad. It's like peak, you know, 2010 era, you know, edge, and it's terrible. Like, Burns is terrible. Every character, like, why, like, the like, Sam has, like his voice is so bad in English. Like, his, there was a real, you know, gravel protagonist voice phase for a little bit there. And yeah, unfortunately, hello, is this gonna, yeah. And unfortunately this game does kind of fall victim for that, you know. Just play Killswitch for the lore. Okay, there we go. That should be enough to take out one more. Man, your friendly AI is not the best. There we are, we got him. That's not gonna get him. Okay, yeah, I'll do this on easy. Whatever. There we go. Oh no, there is one more. Oh, I thought I killed this one. Surprised by Wanted Dead. I think, I thought there was only like three of these. What's up, yes, this is Vanquish. This is the PS3 version though, honestly. If you can play the PC version, I would highly recommend you play the PC version. Because, it's not too bad right now, but there will definitely be parts coming up where the frame rate just does not keep up. Grenades, nice. Right, the statue. There it is. But yeah, I really wish there wasn't so many of these. Because it really makes this playthrough kind of a bit, you know, it's very stop, start, stop, start, stop, start, because I have to keep checking this video. But it's better than RE4 Remake, Louise, yeah. Okay, so we wait until that checkpoint, and then come over to the left. Alright, cool. I gotta be careful that I get trodden on here. I will... Actually, no, I'll keep the sniper rifle for this, but... You know, in all my playthroughs of this, I don't think I've ever fully upgraded the LFE gun. That's gonna squish me. Okay. Okay, that was close. Yeah, okay, now, okay. I think I can get the statue now.
You're out of range to use the wire gun. You need to get those combat engineers beneath the hole.
Yeah, here we go. Okay, where is it? You go past the bus. Oh no, you don't. You don't go past the bus. I came too far. There it is. I should probably get that here. What weapons we got here? Ow, stop shooting me. I'm pretty sure I got the, I can't remember, but I'm pretty sure I got the trophies for like the, you know, kill enemies distracted by a cigarette, and EMP kills. Right, where's the last statue then? Because that was only number 3. What's up, Oxygen? I mean... The challenge trophies are pretty tough in this game, but I have played this game a fair bit, so I've done challenge 6 a few times. I think like the challenge 6 is definitely the hardest, you know, part of this to get the trophy on. Oh, okay, that one's okay. I'm glad I have a sniper rifle for that one.
Sir, we're over the bridge, but surrounded by hostiles. Can you back us up?
Come on.
Elena, why is the suit overheating? Figure it out. Fast.
Hold on. You're too close to the...
I probably should have killed some of those guys. No. Through the EMP. There we are. Thank you. Yeah, I mean, in your own time, buddy, you know. I'm probably not going to be using the sniper rifle much anymore, so... I think that's fully upgraded, right? Yep. I saw a video the other day that said the disc launcher was useless. And I thought, oh my god, how dare you? Yeah, so you see, this bit's pretty choppy right now. Right, I've got every statue now, so I don't need to worry about that. Yeah, disc launcher's really good. The disc launcher is amazing for the, I can't remember what they're called, but you know the, I think it's unknown, the unknown boss. Like, the disc launch is really good for that. Cowards. Okay, I gotta be careful, I don't want to get killed now. Get out of the way. You cretin. I love the disc launcher. And it's super quick to upgrade as well. I don't know if it is the quickest, but it definitely feels like one of the quickest weapons to fully upgrade. You'll notice that the friendly dudes, I don't think they've killed a single robot yet. I should have kept my sniper rifle loose, but... There. Oh, shit. Wait. You. Fucking useless. See what I mean? Just one enemy. And, like, they can't kill just one guy. I'm not sure where the last checkpoint was, so... I'm gonna make sure everyone's dead here. It's the prototype plasma cutter. Yeah, kind of is, actually. Although, speaking of the plasma cutter, the one, I mean, it, you don't have to abuse it as much as I like to be honest, but I think one critique of this game is that I feel like the assault rifle, like your default assault rifle, is just way too good. It is way too strong. The thing absolutely shreds even on hard. Okay. Next chapter.
I'm in.
I got all my statues, right? Yeah, I got four. I missed one in, I wrote down the one I missed. I'll go back and get that later. Okay, I vaguely remember this statue. Okay, and then the next one... isn't... okay, cool. There's only one coming up. Nice.
I'll take this.
Oh, okay. My assault rifle ammo is a little bit low, though. Right, it's, I think you can actually stealth this bit, can't you? If you've got a, sniper rifle. There's the statue. There, there it is. And also, like, this is, like, one of the best parts about this game is just doing this. It's such a cool way to have, like, multiple weapons. Like, it looks so cool. They did indeed, yeah. With Bayonetta. And PC. He is very, yeah, there is definitely a resemblance to Jetstream Sam. Right, the next one coming up is... the frame rate, honestly, is pretty bad. It's playable, but it's you know, in certain parts, it is pretty rough. You know, it took me ages to notice that he's got, like, a red dot sight on his assault rifle. Here we are. So this is the next one coming up. Oh, no. Hang on. This is the boss fight. I didn't miss a collectible, did I? One second. No, I didn't. Okay, it must be after the boss, then. Could do with an... could do with an assault rifle here. Also, EMPs are kind of OP in this game, too. Like, EMP grenades are pretty busted. Sniper rifle. I'm probably not going to need that. Alright, I want to get some more weapons upgraded. Here we are. Now, you can pretty... Yeah, you definitely get ambushed in this room. Ambush this, motherfuckers. That is still... Even though, like, it's a pretty, you know, meta one shit to do. But, man, shooting a grenade and then going into slow-mo and shooting the grenade is... maybe one of the coolest things in this game. Which, again, is also pretty powerful. Okay, so I've got that one. The next one is... I remember this bit. So we go up here. Okay, that's pretty soon, then. Sniper rifle wouldn't have actually been a bad call for this bit. Oh, then why not? Hey, thank you very much.
That drive system is the heart of the beast.
Right,
you can travel
so...
through the ring, but don't get caught inside when the energy is cycling, or you and the suit will be atomized.
I really couldn't get into Max Payne 3. I really liked 1 and 2, but... Wait, hang on, is that... That's... Wait, hang on a minute. I don't think that's the one. Do they... Do those statues say, don't fuck with me as well? Is anyone else hearing that? Okay, yeah, that's statue number 2. Because the one I just shot is definitely not the third one in this video. Oh, no, it is. Oh, it is. He just does it later. Okay. I see. The fourth one. Oh, I don't know. Okay. Well, I might have to... go away. Okay. I'll have to keep my eyes peeled for traveling upwards. Is that a turret? Is that? Can you go away? I really feel like that's not the one. Because that's where I'm going. Well, why not? I love a rocket launcher. Thank you. Yeah, this is definitely where he shoots that statue. And there's not... Yeah, so I must have shot that one from down bottom. Oh, nice. I can't remember. What do grenades max out at? Is it 8? I thought... Yeah, there's definitely not a statue on there. Okay. The fuck? Oh, yeah. How rude. I definitely got 3 statues so far, so as long as we get this next one, we're okay. I also love that you can just do this. I don't know. That's just cool. Right, smoking is not cool. It's not good for you. Right, the next one should be... One second. Oh, so it's not... Okay, it's not until you get right to the door. So I haven't missed it. I like how the rocket launcher has an uppercut. Just straight up. Just, love that. I think it just shows you... Does it show you the level of your weapons? Yeah, it does. Yeah, I think it, it just shows you the level of your weapons. So we've got the assault rifle, shotgun, and disc launcher maxed out. Sniper rifle pretty close. Heavy machine gun not too far off. Yeah, I've never used the LFE gun, so... Here we are. Aha. There we go. What are we going here? Another assault rifle. That's good timing. Take that.
I'll take this.
I really love the upgrade system in this game. Okay, that was weird. It's got to have one of the best video game shotguns ever as well. That was extremely rude. I knew that was going to happen. That grenade. Did I miss that grenade? Did I not shoot the nade? I'm pretty sure I did, but... Because those red dudes definitely should have been dead there.
Vanquish.
I think this is the end of this mission. Do I have to shoot this statue again? Oh no! Oh yeah, you get a checkpoint, don't you? Oh no! Upgrade. Oh, the shotgun is just so good. Right, what we got here? Okay, well, we might as well grab that, because rocket launch is empty, so... Oh, yeah, what's back here? Nice. I guess it's the hoarder in me that loves the upgrade system. Yeah, that's one thing about God Hard I really didn't like. Because I just really like the way the upgrade system works. So no upgrades was a bit. That's a shame.
If you can destroy the pulse source, that should reverse the polarity on the game medium and cause a critical explosion.
What would you say the best weapon is? Okay, where's that? So as soon as you start. Is it on your left? Yeah. Yeah, it's right here, yeah. What? Rip. Assault rifle. Yeah, it kind of is. Yeah. Oh, nice. Yeah, the assault rifle really is pretty OP. Uh-oh. That was the wrong weapon. Assault rifle really is, like, super good. Right, what's the next one? Yeah, so do I, Brizzle. I must admit, though, the you know the DLC weapon pack? The anti-armor pistol, I really like that. I don't have those weapons on PS3. But yeah, the anti-armor pistol is pretty fucking ridiculous. Even, like, without any upgrades, that thing is just... kind of dumb. I could do with getting some more melee kills here and there as well.
You need to take the maintenance room up to the pump source room.
What the?
Just like rock climbing back home.
Yeah, the laser cannon's cool. I just love the animation, you know, when you get the laser cannon. I love the way it builds out. it just looks so good. Right, you can go away. I have a vague... Is there a trophy for killing all of these dropships? Oh. Right, I think this is where the next statue is. What the? Okay. Is that? Oh, you have to go around, okay. I'm kind of glad my first playthrough I didn't have the DLC weapons, though. Especially on normal, because I feel like they would have been a bit too OP. Right, so... What the hell? Oh, wrong side. Can you go away a minute, please? I should probably kill everything. That's a missile. Right, where's the next one? Oops. That's number two. Number three is... Oh, number three is here too. Oh, that's sneaky. Okay, I thought I'd kill him. I'm surprised the game didn't crash then. That was ridiculous. It was like 5 frames a second. I did that on purpose. I thought, I just want to see. Okay, so the next one. Okay, so I think I know where this bit is. This is near the end of this mission. Yep. Ooh, an upgrade. Nice.
I'll take this. This is gonna be fun.
Sweet. Yeah, do you get anything for killing all these dropships? Oh, I finished the first Horus Heresy book last night. Finally. Well, I say finally, it didn't actually take that long to read. There's 64 books in that series, so, you know. Not exactly getting to the, you know, not exactly nearing the end of it or anything, but. I would check if there's a trophy here, but it takes so long to check trophies on the PS3. And these guys just keep coming, so. Get him! No, no. We'll come back. A lot of the middle books are skippable. No. Oh, okay. Yeah, I don't really know, you know, like the tier list of Horus Heresy books. I really did enjoy the first one, though. I really did. I think it gave a lot more character to just a lot of aspects of the universe. I think the lore videos are good. I do like the lore videos. But I guess they kind of have to be. You know, they are pretty, you know, they're pretty brief, I guess. It's a good job that didn't hurt. Where's this ship? What's up, me? I'm doing good, man. How are you? New. Yeah. If there is a trophy there, we'll come back for that one. Oh, hello. In the rear. I mean, yeah, that's true. I mean, a lot of it is, only having read one book, but I do kind of get what people say, because I have watched quite a few lore videos, and I do get what people mean when they say, you know, a lot of this is very subject to interpretation. So. There's some great dialogue in the book, though. I think the lore videos don't quite give the Astartes, especially, like, the personality that I think they actually have. Because after my first, like, forage into lore videos, I was under the impression that the Astartes are basically, you know, robots. Like, they're just completely emotionless. And they're really not. Like, that's not the case at all. And again, maybe that's just the videos I watched. Maybe that was just their, you know, interpretation of Evening Lads. Maybe that's just the way they thought of them, you know. Ow. Oh, he dropped them off, didn't he? Yeah. Well. I mean, God, even that kind of, like, tanked the frame rate a little bit. Right, I've got all the statues, so. Just need to crack on here, really. Might as well get another melee kill. I think you have to kill 100 with melee to get the trophy, which is quite a lot. There's a trophy here for doing something, isn't there? I do know that they're just dancing. Oops. Sorry, lads. Dancing is against the rules.
I'll take this.
Isn't there a boss here? Just let them know. They're robots. They're not allowed to have. They're not allowed to be happy. Oh yeah, here we are. Yeah, he just drops down, doesn't he? Wait, wasn't there a disc launcher in here? It's like, hey, we weren't sure if the shotgun was, like, OP enough. Let's have it when you upgrade it. It shoots incredibly quickly. No, where you going? Actually, I'll wait. There we go. counts for melee, right? I love the shotgun's melee as well. Like, it's just like the most like supercharged bitch slap ever. You know, it's like, oh, it's so good, man. Right, what do I want here? I've never really used the lock-on laser all that much. I feel like that and the LFE gun are about the only weapons that are a bit, you know, a bit whatever. Is there anything else in here? What's it, Reezy? You should definitely play this. Get the PS4 version, though, or the PC version. This is PS3, and it's still good, it's just... It's... The performance does leave a bit to be desired. Okay, right, what's up, Zero? Where's the next statue? Okay, this is the end of Act 3, so... When you think about it, though, every shooter's a cover-based shooter. Even Space Marine. Even, like, the anti-cover-based shooter is still a cover-based shooter. Now, what? Do you have to just kill all the enemies here? Where's that ship? Except Gun Green. Oh, no. Oh, yeah. I'm gonna say. I thought there was supposed to be more, more of you guys. Couldn't that... That rock... Did you see that rocket? Just... completely... That rocket must have had some of Ryu's moonshine. Did you see? That just completely missed. Like... That just completely missed. Like, it didn't even nearly track the ship that I shot it at.
The suit can't take any more hits.
And that was a lock-on, too. Like, dude, I want my money back. Cool. I gotta admit, when you have to get the statues, this game is not nearly as fun. This has taken me quite a few days to get this far, because it's 4 statues in every mission. It's like, come on. That's just too much. Should have been 1 or 2. But that was another trend at this point, though, wasn't there? Games just having a shitload of collectibles in them, you know, that do nothing. I could be wrong, but I don't think the statues in this game actually do anything. You get challenges by progressing through story mode, if I remember rightly. I don't think the statues actually do anything. Which is, and that's even worse, honestly.
Can you see the building in the distance?
Just farming collectibles to unlock, you know, missions and stuff. Oh god, I hate that. It's the thing I really don't like about Arkham Asylum and Arkham City, is to unlock all the challenges, you have to do a shitload of Riddler shit. Okay, so where's this one? Where's that? It's behind a fence. I don't mind collectibles if they're, like, good. You know, if they mean something. I don't like collectibles for collectibles' sake. That just don't do anything. I say, like, these statues just do not do anything. The thermoses in Alan Wake just are completely pointless. I'm trying to think of... Because there are more examples, I just can't think of them off the top of my head. Ah, there it is.
Be careful. There are reports of an enemy sniper team ahead.
I knew that was gonna happen. Those guys hurt, man. The gold dudes. There we go. So that was that statue. What'd you get from... you haven't really got to do much. You pretty much just got to beat the game on hard, get all the collectibles, and finish challenge mode. And that's, like... That will knock out the vast majority of the trophies. There's a few specific things you have to do, but none of them are... You know, none of them are all that difficult. I think, like, challenge mode is the main thing that, like, that's probably the biggest hurdle for most people, is just beating challenge mode. Challenge mode is pretty tough. Like, challenge 6 is... Even if you, like, know challenge 6, it's still no joke. I see you. Thankfully, these guys didn't go to the Halo 2 Jackal Sniper School. Although I'm pretty sure one hit on God Hard does kill you. Hello, sir.
The gate is open.
Yeah, the score. You know what? I was going through my 360 list a while ago, just for old time's sake. And shoutouts to Feo, man. He's got over 1 million gamer score, and I thought, fuck, you know, like, I will never, ever get that much. Mainly because I don't really play Xbox stuff anymore. But I thought, man, 1 million gamer score, that's pretty nuts. Okay, so you come out of the door. Oh, this one's going to be annoying, isn't it? You come out of the door. Oh, no, and that's in a tree. Okay. True, and also, when you beat God Hard, that was a big thing for me. Like, when I beat God Hard, hard mode... I mean, this is on hard, and it's pretty... You know, it's pretty breezy, honestly. It's really not that bad. No, not him. You see that actually lock on to Burns, then? God Hard does make you, like, a significantly better player. What's in front of me? I got that statue, didn't I? Stop shooting rockets at me. Yeah, pretty sure I got that. Nice. I love that mechanic. Hey, what's up, Bonham? You know, for the longest time, I did not know that you could drive these things. I think I'd beaten the game twice before I knew that. And I'm trying to remember how I figured it, how I, like, stumbled upon that. Because I always just used to kill these things. I always just used to destroy the actual... you know, enemy. Whereas if you take out the guy piloting it, you know, you can actually get on them. This is real. Yeah, you should get this, man. This is a sick game. Alright, I think we're at the next statue.
The dam facility is up ahead. Go through it and you've got another elevator you can use.
There is an optional trophy here that I can get as well. I just thought,
enemy
yeah.
RI seem to be readying for a siege and have the place.
Come on.
These RIs are starting to get on my goddamn nerves.
Sorry. That was an honest mistake. Okay, I'll kill the enemies here first, because you get quite a lot of stuff here, if I remember rightly. Also, one thing you've really got to, like, there's a definite Halo level there, is like, well, I don't know if it's, no, level's the wrong word. A Halo similarity. You really do just have to act like your, you know, friendly Marines just do not exist. Because they are absolutely fucking useless. Like, you know, don't think, oh, you know, one guy, like, they'll take care of him. Like, they won't. And I think even on normal, like a melee in this game will kill you. like a melee from like even a regular enemy. If not kill you, it'll put you in AR. Hello. Oh, you fucker. That was what was? Well, you know what? Fuck you. Take that. He ruined my pun. I was gonna say in the rear. I thought I was gonna be. I thought I was gonna get away with that. Oh, I want that revive though. I want that revive. Oh man. Oh wait, no. Is he still there? No, he's not. And they're good. They're really good at doing that too. Just getting in the way of your shots. Right, where's this statue? Ah, there it is. There we are. Right, what's next? Where's the next one? I've been playing Evil West. Oh, I think I got that gifted on Steam. I keep meaning to try that. Okay, so the next one is at the final bit. Oh, yeah, that's an easy one to find. Ugh. Oh, where's that guy that's down? Hello? Get up, you.
Have some juice.
I don't really need that. In the rear.
I'm not picking anything up inside
the... Hey, that's the revive one. Okay, so I don't need to revive anybody. Well, I mean, I will because they give you weapons, but we're good for the... Oh, my assault rifle's pretty low on ammo, actually. Right, so... Yeah, there it is. There was a sniper rifle in there, wasn't there? I think. I taught a sniper rifle. Nope. The overheating is your movement, but also your melee. So when you boost, the green bar will go down. But if your melee whiffs, then you don't, if your melee whiffs, like, you don't, you know, you can do this all day. Oh, my bad. I genuinely didn't see him. Yeah, if your melee whiffs, like, it doesn't burn your meter, but one melee pretty much drains your meter, because your melee is extremely powerful. Like one melee will take like a chunk out of a boss. Like it's your melee's super strong. But if you hold down boost, like one of your earliest things you'll notice is you can like dodge roll like this, or you can like boost dodge roll, but if you hold the boost button and just as soon as it fires up, like you won't actually drain boost gauge, but you can get like a boost dodge. It's kind of like a roll jump in a way. It's like boom, 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 boom. Where that covers more ground than just this, like, so that's just a roll. That's a boost roll. Like, it just covers way more ground. And you have way less meter on God Hard. On Hard, Normal, and Easy, I think meter is the same. Your energy meter. What's up, boy, by the way? Hello. But on God Hard, you get way less. And when you go into, like, bullet time, like that, you get way less on God Hard. Like, it's probably that. You probably get about half as much. I don't know exactly, but it is a lot less. No, what are you doing, Sam? Like, that's such a good move. Like, the kick into cover and then just do, you know, slow-mo after that to take out dudes higher up is, like, super useful. Up Where's the ship? Yeah, the slow-mo is really cool. Ow. In the rear. Okay, that was kind of stupid though, because I might get killed here. All right. Yeah, they are, yeah. I mean, I feel like almost everything is priority one on God Hard, but I know what you mean. Like, on God Hard, it's like, everything is a last boss. Trophy. And if you wonder, so I don't know if I explained it, but you can also like cancel your reload, which is really, really good. So let me kill these dudes. Whoa! I'm falling for no banana in my tailpipe. Yeah, so if you reload and like when you see reload, then just like swap weapons quickly back and forth, you just completely skip the reload animation. Which is really good for weapons like the shotgun. Because you just reload like your entire shotgun magazine practically instantly. Did he survive her? Be quiet. Okay, that hurt. I'll just stun these guys just in case. Rizzle, do you know if, you know when you upgrade your grenades, do they do more damage or do you just hold more grenades? No, you're not. You can't progress in the game without me. Excuse me. Fuck off. Okay, I don't remember there being this many enemies here, honestly. My assault rifle is actually getting low on ammo. My god, they actually killed somebody. Please kill him. I think that's everybody. Oh, larger radius? Okay.
I'll take this.
Ooh, is there another weapon I can swap that for? Do a bit of quality cheese here. Yes, there is. Thank you.
Not what I was after, but it'll do.
Boom. Blast radius. That's nice. That shotgun.
This will come in handy.
Yeah, so the reload thing. So your shotgun, normally. I mean, that's not that long of a reload, but like, if you skip it, it's like there's virtually zero cooldown.
Sam, hit that damn elevator switch.
There we go.
Screw up. Elena, close this door.
Understood. No, my completely useless comrades. Okay, that was the last statue. The reload trick is more is more relevant when your guns aren't upgraded, though. Because, like, when you upgrade your guns, like, you get, like, slightly faster reloads.
This is how the Marines do business.
So at level 1, like, that reload trick is very, very good.
Core country come first.
I only beat God Hard once. Hard is my favorite mode on this, to be honest. I miss my upgrades, man. I love my upgrades. Right, where's the first statue here? What time is it? Oh, it's 6 o'clock already. This week's gone so quick, man. So you come out.
Enemies closing from above.
Oh, these guys. Shotgun. If that heavy machine gun had more ammo, I'd go for it. This game's also on sale quite a lot, Razy. So. Hang on. I can't quite just ignore these guys. Okay. Tried to melee him. Is it on here? Yeah, there it is. Right. Where's the next one? Oh, it's, like, right in front of me. Okay. I should probably kill this guy first. Whoops. I got a little bit too ahead of myself. Okay. In the rear. Oh, I love the shotgun in this game. Alright, where's the next one? Oh, really? I did not know that. That's cool. Alright, where's the next statue? No. Wow, these are really close together. Yeah, the statues definitely say motherfucker. Like, the statues definitely say stuff, don't they? I'm not hearing that. That's not me imagining things. Okay, the next one's quite far away. It's after the boss fight. Okay, cool. That's not for ages yet. What's up, TG? How you doing, man? Was there anything in this... Was there any weapons here? Okay. I do want to get another gun because all my guns are upgraded now, so I wanna. Oh, okay, that's good.
Not what it was after, but it'll
that's
do.
Just that's really not worth dropping anything I have right now, though. That's the only problem. Sorry, heavy machine gun, but. Although I think that and the sniper rifle are the only thing I have left. Nice.
This will come in handy.
Oh wait, don't you get a crystal viper in here? Ooh, lovely. Oh yeah, so man, the next statue is really far away. Yeah. okay, this is bad. Where do you go? There you are, you fucker. Oh, you know what? You are not killing me. Right, so the next one's not until after the boss, which is, well, which is coming up. But... I was just about to say, it's very easy to get trodden on here. Look at that assault rifle damage, man. It was mental. Oh, it's you. Go away. Yeah, I thought so. You basically have to kill this guy twice, don't you? There's so many weapons in this, but... Right, statue. Where's the statue? What weapons we got here, actually?
Not what I was after, but it'll do.
No, that's the disc launcher, isn't it? Oops. I do really like the noise the LFE gun makes, though. Come on, all these weapon crates, there's not another... There we go. Is that a disc launcher? Yep. That's another rocket launcher. Right, the statue is... I think it's through here. Yeah, there we go. I read that as broccoli... I read that as broccoli destruction then. What's up? This game is definitely a hidden gem. Less hidden in this day and age, like there are, like, it is definitely more well known now than it was, you know, when it came out. But yeah, this game is seriously good. Oh, we get the scorpion boots here, don't we? Oh, shit. Oh, there's a trophy associated with that enemy. But I can't remember what it is. I think, yeah. That's true, yeah. I mean, I don't need to do this, but there you go. Wait, you didn't kill this dude? What are some other hidden gems? What are some, like, way more hidden gems? Because I think now it's, you know, depending on the game, you know, it is, you know, games have got way more ways to get known these days. I'm trying to think, what are some games that people still don't know about, but they're really fucking good? How much damage does that? Wow, grenades really do not do much damage to these guys. Like, they really, really don't. I kind of regret dropping my rocket launcher now. I would say Shadow of Rome, but again, I feel like if you're in this stream, you probably know of Shadow of Rome. But Shadow of Rome is definitely, like, criminally underrated. Oh, wait. Oh, I forgot they do that. I forgot about that attack. There we go. Oh, I was stupid. Yeah, I shouldn't have dropped my rocket launcher. People are sleeping on Vengeful Guardian Moonrider. I can't say I've heard of that, so I will definitely... That counts as hidden. What is... You know what? I got one for you. Time Shift. I feel like that game is really underappreciated. That is a really cool shooter. Okay, I'm not going to bother wasting all my grenades on these guys now, because they don't do shit. How fast you fucking fire that shotgun, man. Don't bring a weird, crazy axe to a shotgun fight. Binary Domain is extremely cool. Yeah, I feel like that counts, actually. Because that's a good one, actually. A lot of people know about Vanquish now, but way too few people know about Binary Domain. That game is fucking awesome. Yeah, there was a reason why I don't use the LFE gun that much. Okay, that's it. That's it for this one. Okay, yeah, it doesn't ring a bell. Speaking of 2D shit, has anyone played that new Contra? They did... I don't know if it's a remake. But they did a, they... Was it a remake? I can't remember. But they did, like, a new old-school style Contra. And it came out pretty recently. It's supposed to be very good, but I'm not playing it. Poor Alan's profile. Zone of Enders 2. I definitely know the name, but... Beyond that, I don't know a whole lot. Okay, cool. That's going to do it for me, because honestly, like, this is getting pretty boring, honestly. I really don't like getting all these collectibles. I should have just done an easy playthrough for these. Because on easy, you really can just, you know, ignore virtually every single enemy and just get the statues. It's a lot easier. So, oh, it's a remix of 1, 2, and 3, but mostly based on 1. Oh, okay. Speaking of which, did you guys see, I think someone posted it in Discord, Dead Space 2 Remake apparently has been shelved. Because the first game didn't sell enough. What's up, QC? Oh man, if you just joined, bad timing. I'm literally just wrapping up now. Because I didn't start until a bit later. So, I'm hungry, man. My din-dins. But yeah, no Dead Space 2 Remake. Which, you really don't need to remake Dead Space 2, but I mean... that's not a game I would have said no to. Do you know what I mean? If they did, you know, if they just made Dead Space 2 just look like the remake, I admit, you know, I would have bought that 100%. But yeah, apparently that got shelved. I have a feeling that I'm gonna check my Steam actually for them, because I say I'm pretty sure Valent gifted that. It's on my list. But yeah, I'm pretty sure Dead Space Remake sold well, but when EA say a game didn't sell well, it basically means, yeah, this game didn't make all the money in the world, so it's, you know, it's a failure. But I'm pretty sure the remake sold pretty decently. Yeah, let's check Steam here real quick. Oh, Foxy's back on. Ooh, Ermac Combat Cast on Monday. Nice. Yeah, where are we? Steam. I'm pretty sure I have that one. But yeah, I think Dead Space Remake did... I think it did like 2 or 3 million. Like, it sold. I mean, that's good numbers, man. For any game. But... yeah, where are we? Here we are. Dead Space 2023. Sales. It was the best-selling game in January the month it came out. I mean, that's not super surprising. It was kind of the only thing that really came out in January. Well, that I can remember. Oh yeah, what's up, Chris? Thank you for the raid, sir. Welcome, people. We're just talking about the Dead Space 2 remake being canned, which is unfortunate. Yeah, do I have Evil West? I'm pretty sure I do. I think that's in the backlog. Yes, it is. Right under Engard. Yeah, I do have Evil West. Yeah. I get that confused with another game that came out that wasn't very good. Well, that supposedly wasn't very good. I also want to see if I can get San Andreas running on PC, because that PS3 version is not really the way I want to play that. So. You know what, Paul Allen's profile? You know what I think you have to thank for that? The internet. I think there was definitely a time where American Psycho references were definitely, you know, a certain club, you know, only got the references. But now that American Psycho has been, like, meme to fuck on the internet, like, everyone, you know, like, let's see, you know, when someone shows something, it's like, well, let's see so-and-so, so-and-so, and it's a reference to, like, let's see Paul Allen's card. So, yeah, I get what you mean by that. There was definitely a time where American Psycho was what's the word? You know, it wasn't an actual meme that everyone knew about. It, you know, but yeah, now people do. The Dead Space Remake sequel wasn't actually going to be, really? Because that's not what that's not what the news thing mentioned. I mean, I feel like that would have been a pretty bad move, honestly. You have Dead Space 2, you literally have like a blueprint of, in my opinion, one of the best games ever made. So just copy paste that game with better graphics and boom, you have. I wonder if they'd have done the multiplayer actually. Probably not, knowing EA. Although I don't know, maybe they would have. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe they would have. Because it's funny, I thought the same thing about Dead Space 1 in the Dead Space Remake, rather. When you play that game having not played Dead Space 2 in a while, it feels very much like Dead Space 2. You play that game and you think, yep, like they just kind of made this into Dead Space 2. Then you go and play Dead Space 2 again and you think, holy fuck. That game is something else, man. Dead Space 2, especially on PC. Oh lord. It's just so unbelievably fast. And that remake borrows heavily from 2, but it does not have the speed that Dead Space 2 has. Dead Space 2, oh man, that is such a good game. I'm not even remotely joking when I say that's one of the best games ever made. That's good shit, man. I have that on PC too. I should play that more. But yeah, no Dead Space remake. No Dead Space 2 remake, rather. Which is annoying because that means that we're not going to get a Dead Space 3 remake. And of those two games, you know, 3 would benefit from a remake a lot more than 2 would. But, you know, we would have to have gone through Dead Space 2 to get a Dead Space 3 remake. Which sucks. So. But yeah, no sales numbers on it, though. Dead Space remake sales numbers. Because I could be imagining things, but when that came out, didn't they, weren't they happy with how it did? I remember, I don't know if it was official, but I remember hearing, you know, good things about its sales. Here we are. It cracked 2 million. It just says here, yeah, so this is not official, but it just says it cracked 2 million quickly. So yeah, I guess they changed their mind. That's a shame. Oh, here we are. No, never mind. I thought this was actually going to be sales numbers. This article is mentioning Callisto Protocol. Man, remember the hype over that game? I still have to have that to play. I've still got that on PS5. I mean, here's the thing, right? So here's a sales. Here's your sales charts for the US for the month of January. Dead Space was number 2, only behind Modern Warfare 2. It's above Madden and FIFA. Like, if you're outselling Madden and FIFA, you know, only a few months after those, like, you're doing well. But yeah, not well enough apparently. Nah. That's a real shame. I was looking forward to that, I will say. We have the Silent Hill 2 remake. Is that this year? Is anyone getting that? There was also that rumor that Gears of War 6 is going to be revealed in a couple of months. If you're not worried about that game, I don't know what to tell you. Yeah, what was I going to look up real quick? Yeah, Silent Hill 2. Is Silent Hill 2 out this year? Oops. Yeah, I mean, to be fair, that's just because it didn't work. It didn't work on PC, and I just couldn't be arsed. It wasn't necessary. It wasn't because the game was bad. It's just because it didn't fucking work. Okay, so it's coming soon on Steam. Yeah, I mean, I really hope Gears 6 is good, but that game is following so closely in the footsteps of Halo Infinite that expecting anything out of that game other than a train wreck, I think, is pretty naive. I mean, Gears 5 was how many years ago now? 2019, I think. 2019. So that game's been in development for like 5 years or more, and we have seen absolutely nothing of it. That is never a good sign. And I enjoyed Gears 4 and 5, but that's a series that you can tell they just did not want to let go of, because they had a different approach, you know, at the time. Gears, like the tail end of the 360 era, Microsoft had a different approach. So I think, you know, the fact that we are still getting new Gears games is just a carryover of that. I think they should do Gears 6 and then just move on. Just do something else. So it's honestly, Danger, as I can recall, it's always the latter. Because if they have something to show, if they actually have something to show that's good, they will show it. Because that's good for the game. I think you can look at no better example than Halo Infinite. They didn't show that game for what, like, almost 6 years? And we all know why. It's because they didn't have anything to show. And, you know, the history book has been written on that. And I think Gears 6 is kind of the same. You know, that game has been in development for a long time. And they haven't shown it. And it's a very... And it's a known quantity, too. If it's a unique game, you could understand it. You know, if it was something like... I don't know. I'm trying to think of an example. If it was a game that was like new, if it was trying something new, or if it was a new developer on a new engine, like Gears 6 is just gonna, it's another Gears game. You know, Halo was going to be another Halo game, and after that amount of time, like, they've got nothing to show. It's a bad sign. BG3 took 6 years to make. Is that BG Baldur's Gate? Oh, Baldur's Gate 3. Yeah. Three years to early access. What, as in it? Wait, as in it was in? What do you mean 3 years to early access? Yeah, but is Elden Ring's kind of an example though. Like, is Elden Ring like really that different than, you know, the games they've made before? And it's the same engine, right? So when you have a game like Gears, which, let's be serious here, Gears 6 is just going to be Gears 5 copy and pasted with some new shit in it. Gears 5 was just Gears 4 copy and pasted. Like, it's the games at their core are very, very similar. I hope it's good, though. I do. I don't want Gears 6 to be bad, but I didn't want Halo Infinite to be bad either, and yet, you know, what, you know, you don't get everything you want. You don't always get what you want, so... Right. Anyway, I'm hungry. What time does... Oh, no, it's too early for TGD, isn't it? Yeah. Never mind. Long period in early access. Oh, really? I don't know that. Yeah, but I mean, they delivered on that game, so... Cyberpunk was another one. Although I will say, when they showed Cyberpunk, it actually looked pretty goddamn good. That first showing of Cyberpunk looked really good. And then the game came out, and, well, we all know what happened with that, don't we? Can you buy that game on PS4? It's 'cause you know a game is bad when they actually pull it from the shop. You know, that's real bad. Yeah, okay, it seems like you can get it on there now. Yeah, you can you can get it on PS4. I would still like to go back to that at some point, you know. I really would. But I don't know if I'll have the time in the near future. I enjoyed Cyberpunk, so I didn't know shit about the game. I mean, did anyone really know anything about it other than it was hella cyberpunky? I feel like that game could have been subtitled Cyberpunk. Because that was sort of the... And when was that game first revealed? It was ages ago, wasn't it? I remember because I was still doing my podcast with my Giant Bomb friends at the time. Because I remember we saw the reveal for it. And, you know, everyone on the forums was going mental. And it was like, dude... It was... Like, they basically showed a GIF. That's it. And you people are getting crazy hyped about it, you know? Like, this is going to be the best game ever! I was like, based on what? It's crazy. I think there's a lot to be said for not following games media these days. It's all the same. It's all the same. Now that games media, like games journalism, whatever you want to call it, games coverage, you know, whatever word you want to use, now that it's all... Not all of it, that's not entirely true. A decent chunk of it is just hanging by a thread. it just has no identity anymore. You know, that everything is just, like, look at Stellar Blade, right? This is not like I'm, you know, Charles Xavier here, but that game, the reason that we know so much about that game is because Cyberpunk is the reason I bought a 3090. Oh, nice. I didn't have a 3090 when I tried it, so. But yeah, Stellar Blade, that game has caused up such a shitstorm because of the way games coverage is these days. Because they know that all they've got to do is, you know, make some really clickbaity or provocative title, you know. And they know people will click on it. They know people will send the rounds on it. They know people will make videos about it. Like, they know that that will work. If that game had a male main character, we probably wouldn't even be talking about it. So, and it's going to completely overshadow the game. You know, when that game comes out, it could be legitimately amazing. But we all know what's going to happen when that game drops. It's just going to be nothing but posts about, you know, the main character. There's that costume in there where she's practically naked. That's all people are going to talk about. And you think the game could actually be really good, and yet all that people are going to talk about is, oh my god, this female character, like, this female is maybe sexualized too much in media. And you think, well, what else is fucking new? You know, Wonder Woman isn't wearing overalls and a t-shirt. You know, she's wearing a, like, very flattering skirt and corset for a reason. It's because she's hot and sex sells. And the fact that people are still, you know, I don't know what the word is, but, like, but the fact that that's something we haven't moved on from in the journalist / coverage medium, in terms of, this is still something that can be used to pull in traffic and that. Like, that's, it's kind of sad, honestly, when you think about it. So, initially had the 1080, bought a 3060 Ti, didn't like the performance, and gave it to mate and bought the 3090. Yeah, I've said this on, I think, a recent stream. I kind of regret getting my 3090, to be honest. Well, not regret, that's the wrong word. I could definitely put that money to better use right now if I had it. You know, that money would come in handy for the house, but because I've only played like one game since getting that, and that was RE4 Remake. But yeah, you know, in a few years' time, I'll probably be really glad I have it though, because, you know, a 3090 will do me for quite a while. So, but yeah, it's like, although I will say, it is really good for video editing. I'll say that I do forget about that, actually. Like, that thing crushes video rendering, which is great. Like, it's probably halved the amount of time it takes me to render videos, which is really, really cool. So, anyway, dudes and dudettes, that's gonna do it for me. I'm hungry. I'm gonna get some food. I will catch you over the weekend at some point. I'm really not sure what I'm gonna play this weekend. I really don't want to get back to the blindfolded run yet, so that's not gonna be this weekend. I just really don't want to play that at the moment. I really, really don't. I might play World at War, actually. Yeah, I've got World at War to play. I'm looking at my initial, like, PS3 stuff to play. Yeah, I might play World at War. That's a nice, you know, quick game. So, yeah. And, yeah, I hope to see some of you guys there. I will catch you tomorrow. Peace.